Hi, I'm Kaylin, and this is Bible Science with Kay. Today, we're going to learn about density and buoyancy. I would like to give a big shout out to Tammy for giving this week's awesome experiment idea. If you have an experiment idea, please let us know on one of the links below. Next, I'm going to tell you the supplies you will need. Actually, this week, we're doing two experiments. So I'm only going to tell you the supplies for the first experiment, and then when it's time to do the next experiment, I'll tell you the supplies you will need for the next one. Mom? So the supplies you will need for the first experiment, two plastic cups, two oranges, and for safety, a lab coat and goggles. First, you're gonna pour water into two plastic cups. Then you're gonna peel an orange. Next, I want to tell you that this one feels heavier. I'm pretty sure that when I put these two in the water, this one is going to sink. Let's see what happens. What? That doesn't make any sense. Next, I'm going to tell you why this one flowed and this one sank. Well, the peeling is heavier, but the peeling has little pockets of air in it, and it makes it float. And that is called buoyancy. What is buoyancy, you might ask? Buoyancy means it floats. Next, I'm going to tell you the supplies you will need for the second experiment. Two food colorings. They have to be a different color, whatever color you want, but different colors. It doesn't have to be a yellow one, but some kind of waterproof card. Four of the same kind of container, and the pan is just to make sure you don't make a huge mess. First, you're going to put cold water into one of your jars. Then you're going to take whichever color you want, put 10 drops in, and then gently stir. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Now I'm going to gently stir. I wish it could be the same color so then I could mix the red and the blue up to make purple. Because purple is one of my favorite colors. It just looks the same. Next, you're going to do the exact same thing with another jar, except you're going to fill it up with hot water, and do the exact same thing except with the other color of food coloring. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. I almost did 11. Now gently mix it up. Whoa, it's kind of like turning, it looks an orange, it either looks orange or blood red. Yeah, it looks orange and blood red to me. Next, my mom is going to come and do it for me, and I don't even know what she's doing because it's going to be a surprise. Mom.
Hi.
So,
what did I do?
I see her putting the card on, and then she's flipping it over. She's flipping the red over, the hot water, and she's putting it on the cold water, and I don't know what she's doing.
Do you think they're gonna mix?
I'm pretty sure they're gonna mix.
You think they're gonna mix a lot or a little?
I just think they're gonna mix. I don't know. Wait, what? How are they not mixing?
Good question.
How are they literally not mixing? I don't even, my mom's a scientist, but I don't even know how they're not literally mixing. They're supposed to be mixing! This makes no literally sense. Okay. What's in the world?
Now, hang on.
Next, she's going to do the exact same thing that she did with this one, except she's going to do it, except the hot water's going to be on the bottom and the blue water's going to be on the top. And, yeah. I think it's not going to mix.
You think it's not going to mix again?
Yeah. Okay. You have a smirk smile.
I have a smirk smile.
No way! That's impossible! That can't be. With this one, it's not mixing, but with this one, it's mixing.
I know.
This is making no sense. Mom, you're a magic person.
I'm a magic person.
Now, how does she do it? The hot water is less dense than the cold water, so the cold water likes to be on the bottom, and the hot water likes to be on the top. So when the hot water is already on the top and the cold water is already on the bottom, they stay how they are. But when the cold water is on the top and the hot water is on the bottom, they switch. And if they're in colors, they accidentally mix. I rhymed. So the Bible lesson of this is putting on the armor of God. For the oranges, when you put on the armor of God, it's like the water's sin, and we're the oranges. The peel of this orange is like the armor of God. And when we put the armor of God on, we flow and we don't sink into sin. But when we take the armor of God off and we don't put it on, we sink into sin. And it connects with this one because the armor of God lets us stand firm so we don't mix into the devil. But when we're on the wrong side and we're on the devil's side, we mix into a bad color that we don't want to be. Now I'm going to share a Bible verse with you. Ephesians 6:11. Put on the full armor of God so that you will be able to stand firm against the schemes of the devil. Thank you for watching my show. Please like and subscribe to my channel.